All contents presented here are selected and translated from Steve Wang's keynote speech during Infocom China 2019. Steve Wang is the president of VNS Incorporated, who is the brand owner of GeoBox. GeoBox provides high-end video processor for pro AV applications. This is one of the most impressive user cases of large-scale projection project done by TeamLab. There are totally 470 units of projectors are used together with 120 GeoBox controllers, for an area over 10,000 square meters. This is another one presented last year in Paris. Various of effects are created to provide immersive and interactive experiences for visitors. If you are interested, the showcase video link will be shared at the bottom of this video. A completed large-scale projection system consists of four subsystems. They are input source, video wall settings, image alignment with edge blend, and projection. What needs to be aware of that if PC is adopted as the solution for other subsystem, mostly you can only use PC as the input source, and would be difficult to use other input devices. However, if a non-PC solution is adopted for other subsystems, then any digital devices can be used as input source, for example, media players, game console, camera, and of course PC. Further to explain the video wall setting. It consists of two processes. One is image split. This means to split the image and distribute them to multiple projectors in assigned orders. Another one is overlap setting. In order to combine images seamlessly, some contents must be doubled at the edge between every two images, then they can be blended with no gap. Third subsystem is align and edge blend. Due to various on-site installation factors, such as screen size, throw distance, or if you need to project your image on a regular surface, geometry of projector images need to be adjusted before edge blending. Sometimes, you might even need functions like edge mask or shift to get rid of redundant content. Let's start to talk about how to choose right solution for your projection system. Firstly, when you use PC as the input device, which is still the most common way of doing, you will then decide to keep using PC or non-PC for other subsystems. We will talk about using PC to process other subsystems later. Here we want to firstly summarize some obvious advantages of using non-PC solution for other subsystems. First, you don't need to worry about content format anymore, and you will be free to adopt any other external input devices as the second or third inputs, for example an interactive application. Additionally, you will be rather flexible in resolution adjustment. Easy maintenance is also an important advantage of non-PC solution, as the geometric fine-tuning can be done easily using remote control. This is the scenario of using PC as input device as well as the video wall setting. The alignment and edge blending work are done by high-end projectors with such functionalities. In this scenario, multiple graphic cards are needed in order to output to multiple projectors. And in order to do the overlap setting, the graphic card must have the capability to properly crop and create overlap images, which might not be done using generic graphic cards but high-end ones, and they are usually much more expensive. Additionally, how to have those images from multiple cards synchronized properly will be a big issue that needs to be considered. Next scenario is to extend the usage of PC further to handle the work of alignment and edge blending, as some PC software does provide the total solution. In this scenario, of course, you need an even higher performance PC equipped with very powerful CPU and GPU to handle the complicated system. When PC performance cannot catch up, you won't be able to play the video smoothly, and cannot get the images synchronized properly. Besides, as most PC resource is already consumed by processing above complicated tasks, it'll become even more complicated if you want to adopt other external input devices, such as interactive application. Next, we'd like to talk about some different non-PC solutions. Firstly, you can consider using video wall controller to do the video wall setting and use projector embedded with alignment and edge blending functions to handle the rest of processes. There are many advantages for this kind of solution. The most obvious one is, as mentioned earlier, any input device can be adopted. Secondly, it's very easy to increase the system resolution, and it is very flexible to show various display modes if it's requested. Video wall controller is an hardware which you can use to split image and assign them to multiple projectors, and in the same time, you use video wall controller to create and set up overlap required for projector edge blending. This is a configuration of an 8K 1K display system, feeding the 8K content directly to video wall controller, and use controller to split the image with necessary overlap, and then distribute them to projectors. Comparing to PC-based solution, this is a much simpler configuration if your project requires high resolution. Another advantage, if the video wall controller is embedded with matrix function, you can use it to create different display modes, which means to switch among multiple sources to multiple displays. For example, you can choose to display different contents on the full screen, or to display one content on two projectors and the other content on the other two projectors, or to display four discrete content on four projectors. Moreover, for the case when projector needs to project in portrait mode, you can use video wall controller to crop and rotate the image easily without modifying the source content. If source content need to be changed constantly, for example, in retail space, you can just switch your source from one to the other, then it's ready to play. You don't need to modify the source content. This will help save you a lot of time and effort. One additional advantage, you can use video wall controller to adjust the aspect ratio according to the needs. For example, to stretch the image to fit into the full screen, or to keep original ratio and shift it to the middle of screen. Following is another type of non-PC solution, the Edge Blender. An Edge Blender is a hardware for doing video wall settings, alignment and edge blending in one box. All above mentioned advantages of video wall controller are also the advantages of Edge Blender. Besides, as Edge Blender is embedded with geometric alignment and edge blending function, you can choose projectors based on project optical requirements, like brightness, resolution, and throw ratio. Edge Blenders also provide additional functions which are useful. For example, PIP and POP, which can be used to further extend the display flexibility. Corner wall correction is a useful function of Edge Blender, which enables geometric alignment at the corner, so you can project images like the picture shown, no matter on the pillars, or an image on connected wall and floor, to create an immersive watching experience by using just one projector. In order to make a really smooth blended image, Edge Blenders also provide some advanced features to align the color and black level of overlap areas. Edge Blender can align color by RGB and a different brightness level. Black level uplift is also a useful function to compensate different black level at overlap areas caused by projector light leakage. It is necessary to have 9 region adjustment if you have projectors blended both vertically and horizontally. Projection mapping is another advanced feature newly available on the Edge Blenders. Most projection mapping solutions are done by cropping or masking from the source content, so when you switch to another content, you have to do the mapping again. On the other hand, when mapping is done by Edge Blender, you will firstly create and load the pattern into Edge Blender, then, you can have different contents played on those patterns without any modification to the source content. After comparing different options of building the large-scale projection system, we want to touch base on how to decide resolution for projection system, because this will lead to a critical decision about quantity and specs of projectors and input source. First, an important concept to share, picture quality is perceived according to the watching distance and pixel pitch. The closer the watching distance is, the smaller pixel pitch it has to be. That's why the pixel pitch of the outdoor LED wall can be quite big, but looks fine from far away. In our experience, when watching from the distance of 1 meter away, pixel pitch needs to be equal or less than 1 millimeter. Pixel pitch is calculated by dividing the image size with resolution. Let's make an example. If watching distance is 5 meters and image size is 20 meters wide, then in order to have 5 millimeters pixel pitch, system resolution needs to be at least 4K, and that means the whole the system need to support the resolution of 4K or above. Lastly, we want to share our step-by-step planning when moving forward to system implementation. First, there are some on-site information we must know, including image size, space limitation, ambient light and content resolution. Based on image size and space limitation including watching distance, we can decide minimum system resolution. Based on ambient light, we can decide the required lux, which means the final brightness on screen. Then, based on required system resolution, lux value, and space limitation, we can further simulate on our planning tool, to come up with an installation plan, including required quantity and key specs of projectors. This is our self-developed multi-projector planning tool. We first enter the image size, resolution, projector specs, quantities, and overlap, then it will give simulation on final image size, lux value, system resolution, location of projector installation and other information needed during implementation. This can be really helpful for your project planning. Detailed information about this useful planning tool can be found in another video, which will be listed on the bottom of this video.